Good morning, good afternoon to all of you, and welcome to our June open session, GMRT session. We've been really busy training some new facilitators that we hope to introduce to you next month. But this month is a special month for a play that was done by Divya and I on Eric Carlin. Divya, would you take over for me, please?
Thank you, Tracy. So Tracy introduced me. Believe me, I hadn't heard of Eric Carle before this. When she told me about him, I went Googled him, found his biography. I think that in one day, I read about 15 of his stories and I was completely captured by his books and his thoughtfulness about children, about what they feel. It did not seem that this man was in his 70s or 80s. It seems like he was inside those children's mind, the way he was able to write about them. I love the bit about hope, how they are talking about hope in this. It is so relevant. He must have written this book 50 years back, but it is still so relevant to today's time. That's what I felt when I saw this video, when he's talking about hope for the caterpillar, because it's going to fly and go out into the world and then, you know, become something. So it's so appropriate for every child to believe in that you are going to become a butterfly.
Well, and it's also very important for all of us to believe, because as we went through our training and learning with the GMRT, once we graduated as butterflies.
Yeah, but also
very much of a symbol of our work as well. So that is even more, you know, special. Would you like to share the script?
Can you do it? Because I'm not ready with that. Yes. I'm sorry.
I can do that. Oh, can everybody see this okay?
Yeah. Yes.
So there, those that do know the Hungry Caterpillar, you might see other animals from some of his other books. Do you recognize any of them?
Sloth, spider, ladybug, brown bear. What is cricket? Is it a kind of animal?
Mm-hmm. What is cricket? That's a good question. Does anybody know and can help?
Yeah, you? I know.
Yuk, what?
Yeah, cricket is like, you know, chirping sound, an insect type you makes a chirping sound.
You're saying chirping sound?
No, ma'am. It makes a cricket sound like. I don't know how to, you know, tell that pronounce, like, but I know that it is an insect which makes a cricket sounds.
Do you know how they make it?
The ants, ma'am,
they are like the grasshopper.
Yeah, good. Okay. How do they make their sound?
With this neck, or like, think.
Anybody else have an idea of how crickets make this? We actually have a little script that talks about how the cricket makes their music.
First, then we can understand what the cricket.
Okay, all right. Let's check. Divya, you wanna try and give out parts?
Who is your butterfly? By Divya Gupta and Stacy Hansen. It was a Sunday afternoon, and a tiny caterpillar wound its way out of a tiny egg. Now, this tiny caterpillar is very, very hungry and decides to get some to eat.
Oh, what a bright sunny Monday morning. Do I see an apple there?
Just as he is about to bite on it, he starts feeling lonely. He's missing the warmth of his leg. And then he spots a very quiet cricket who seems to be feeling lonely too.
Very quiet cricket. What brings you here?
Yog?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, actually, I don't know the dialogues.
You have to read it from there, Yog. You just have to read this. You have to look. Your role is the cricket's role, no? So just read the cricket's dialogue.
But where it is?
Can't you see the screen? Can you see the screen?
Right here. Do you see it?
Oh, now I can see.
Okay.
Cricket. Very sorry. I was looking for my friends, but I am unable to find them. I can't talk with others. They don't understand me. They don't chirp.
I will help you find your friends and you can help me find food as I am a very, very hungry caterpillar.
Together, the caterpillar and the cricket starts looking for friends and food.
It's Tuesday today and we have not been able to find my friend.
Don't worry, we will. I can see a pear tree and two pears are on the ground.
The very hungry caterpillar devours the pears. Just as he is finishing, he sees an obnoxious looking chameleon.
Well, what are you?
I'm the mixed up chameleon. I just wanted to have the powers of the other animals who seemed better than me. But look at what happened to me.
You do look unique.
Remorse, work on that. I am sure you will be back to your old self soon.
We have been walking for a day. It's Wednesday. No sign of food and no changes in me.
There, I can see a spider. Let's ask him.
The very big spider is hard at work.
Hello, spider. Can you direct us to some food? I am a very, very hungry caterpillar.
My barnyard friends were talking about some fresh plums in the garden, but you'll have to look for them. I'm afraid I can't help you as I have to finish this web today.
Yes, I can see the juiciest plums ever.
Caterpillar ingested the plums with mighty speed.
Thank you, very busy spider. We will wait for you to finish your web. Then you can join us to look for more food.
The very busy spider joins them reluctantly.
I shouldn't have come with you. I had so much work to do. Sun has risen and set. Today is Thursday.
Be patient, my friend. Let us look for some more food as I am very, very hungry. What is that brown bear doing?
I'm telling everyone about the beautiful colors around us, the beauty of nature, how diverse and colorful it is.
Brown bear, what do you see? Do you see any food for which I am very, very hungry?
I can see some red strawberries.
The caterpillar gobbles the strawberries and requested the brown bear to come alone to tell them about the plethora of colors in nature.
I'm feeling tired of talking. Let's rest for a while. It's been 24 hours since I joined you. It's Friday today.
What a glorious day it is, but alas, I can't think beyond my hunger pangs as I am very, very hungry.
Just then they heard some grumbling and saw a ladybug.
It's a beautiful day today. Dear ladybug, would you be kind enough to tell me where I can find some food as I am very, very hungry?
Don't ask me. I'm Grouchy Ladybug, and if you bother me, I might challenge you to a duel. Anyways, you're too tiny to be much of a fighter. So if you want, you can have this aphid.
No, thank you, and you can drop the attitude. Have you forgotten the blue wool?
Just then, the animals see an orchard bracket with orange trees.
I'm humbled. Let's go see if we can get the oranges.
I seem to have become bigger after eating 5 oranges, but I am still very, very hungry.
The ladybug joins them in search of more food.
What kind of habitat is this? Why is it so difficult to find any food here? It's Saturday today and I haven't seen any leaves. Forget about the efforts.
We will find something. And better be soon. I'm feeling faint.
Greetings. I am slowly, slowly sloth. I could not help but overhear. Please wait. I have a feast which I collected over a long time, as I am slow, but not lazy.
The sloth offers them chocolate cake, ice cream, pickles, cheese, salami, lollipop, cherry pie, sauces, cupcake, and watermelon. They all ate to their heart's content.
Maureen?
Did she fall off?
Maureen?
I have eaten so much. I think I'm going to burst.
The caterpillar decides this indulgence needed a break. The next day, he decides to look for a leaf because that was all that the very, very hungry caterpillar could eat that day.
It was easier.
Can I be the caterpillar as well?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, it was easier to find some sumptuous food. Why can't I find a simple leaf?
They see flickering light in some distance and are astounded to see that it is moving towards them. When it gets closer.
Who are you? Are you from the outer world? How do you make your own light?
I am the very lonely firefly, and I'm looking for my friends.
I'm looking for a leaf as I'm not so very, very hungry anymore.
I did see some while flying out here. Let me direct you.
The very lonely firefly takes them to a tree which looks splendid with its flora.
I can only have one leaf and then no more. Now I will take some rest.
The other animals are wondering where the caterpillar has taken off. All they could see was a
chrysalis
on the leaf.
Where? This is everybody.
Where is our friend?
A very hungry,
very, very hungry caterpillar.
And voila, the grubs, when they saw a beautiful butterfly emerge from it, she circled over them. She was the one who had got them together, so they were not so lonely anymore. Who is your butterfly?
Yay! Such a beautiful story. Such a beautiful story.
So let's talk a little bit about what you thought of the story. Did you enjoy it?
I really loved it.
Of course.
Tell us a little bit about what you enjoyed and what you thought about it.
Well, what I enjoyed was I have always tried to be the butterfly, but people were like, I'm being too good to be true or I'm faking it. But in the end, maybe they got the idea that actually I was trying to bring them together because I myself was alone.
Anybody else want to share their thoughts about the story?
Nazifa, I'm sure you have something to say.
Yeah, I might can say something. Actually, I love the parrot when the caterpillar actually turned to a butterfly. And
I have noticed that every single time the caterpillar go to someone, they would help him or her. Let's say him, okay, that caterpillar, that guy. So they would help that guy, but first they would be like, I'm so busy. Oh, I'm the what ladybug. Like they were talking about themselves and they were showing that they're too busy to help them, but even though they're doing that. So it is kind of a passive aggressive way to tell people that I'm too busy for taking care of you or helping you in any way. But anyways, I'm a good person, so I'm helping you. So that's kind of a thing, like you are getting what you need, but you have to like pay it with your self-esteem. Like people are going to insult you at first and be like, oh, why are you disturbing me? But then they would be like, oh, I'm a good person. So that's the reason why I'm helping you. So in the end, like the caterpillar has been with them this whole time, but they kind of ignored him. And they wanted to talk him away. But in the end, when they saw that the caterpillar is gone, that's when they realized that they has lost the friend.
It's about inspiration. Like living life lonely is not the actual reason that you have to be sad or your days will go bad. You can be better next time. Whenever you are alone, you are lonely, you can have friends. And here, you can see at the last time, all the animals were just trying to find out where the caterpillar is. So that's why you can see here a bond where from the starting to the end, the caterpillar was talking with other animals and asking where it can find food and other accessories. And the animals were also helping it. Yeah. And the last time when it just came as a butterfly, it shows its colors and it's different look, and they were just surprised that they have just helped a caterpillar, but it turned into a beautiful butterfly.
This little caterpillar comes out of an egg, and there's nobody there, right? Just hatched. It's not when we're born, you know, we have a mom, a family, and all that. With no guidance and no help, and not knowing what to do except knowing that he's hungry. And
yes, ma'am.
And in his search, he ends up finding friends or resources that help him to be able to get what it is that the little caterpillar needed. In this case, it was food. But in our cases, when we're sort of in the center there, if you think of the matrix as the learner, we have resources that we reach out to help us to reach our full potential.
Yes, ma'am.
So couldn't we look at that little caterpillar as sort of the learner in the center? And then to think about all of those other animals as the resources around him that helped him find the answer or see who he really was to help him to become that butterfly.
To reach the full potential, right? To reach the full potential. But
and I felt that all the characters, they were not really boasting, but they were coming up with their problems. Some character was lonely, some was grouchy. They had all had issues. And when they came to God, when I wrote about the script and when the reading was happening, more than when you are writing, when people are reading it with their inputs, I realized that all these characters had their problems. They came together. And when the caterpillar, the caterpillar was the string which was connecting them. So he was the one who was, the spider was busy. So he said, no, you come along with. So he's basically trying to group all of them together. And in the end, they all thought of him as a friend. And when he wasn't there, he's like, oh my God, where is he? Then they saw the butterfly. And then they were kind of, then they realized that, oh, we have to be grateful to the butterfly because we all had our issues. But when we got together, we were just looking for food for the caterpillar because poor thing is hungry. So they forgot their own problems. They got a common cause. So that is why the title, why do you think the title is there? Who is your butterfly? So a person who's getting you together, so you kind of forget your own problems. And there's another common cause. Everybody over here, I'm sure, has some issues. Some have physical health issues, mental health issues, financial issues, social issues, emotional issues, everybody. But when we come here, we kind of forget those. We are thinking about reading the script. Oh my God, what word is this? I can't pronounce it right. I'm thinking, you know, and I'm like, oh my God, did I mispronounce it? Am I using the correct intonation? Is my voice sounding okay? So those are the thoughts. And suddenly I forget about all my worries. So, you know, that is the thing. That is what we have to think of. Nakshi, I know all of us have troubles. But that is why this platform becomes so important. And when I was writing this, when I wrote, who is my butterfly? Who is your butterfly? I was thinking of Tracy. I was like, she's the one who got all of them together.
Yes, for sure. So for sure. Me,
she was the butterfly. I was about to tell you that Tracy is her butterfly.
Yes. You go back and look at the story again. I see, you know, Brown Bear who tried to help out and offer them food. And you know, and the different animals did try to offer something. But the caterpillar still isn't satisfied with it because it's not quite enough. It's not quite enough. Okay. And, you know, the fact that in the end, that the caterpillar finally was able to overcome the issue of it's hungry or it's mental illness or it's mental or whatever the issue that each of us is dealing with, to be able to become that butterfly and to share that out with others, you know. So the interpretation of a story often comes from where we are in our own personal life and how we're feeling. As Divya was saying, she didn't see that. And when she was writing it, it was really a happy story showing how the different characters and resources helped the caterpillar reach the full potential of becoming a butterfly. And in your interpretation is so different because of your whole mental situation, which is equally important and interesting to see. Mamtez, hello, it's nice to see you here. I don't know if you got in here early enough to be able to hear the story. It was a pretty cool story. Can you introduce yourself and...
Okay, Tracy, how are you? Good evening from Bangladesh. I have added one educators and two students from Bangladesh in your program from Bangladesh. I would like to introduce them. Professor Shamsuddin Talukdar, he is most popular and prominent educator of Bangladesh. And our little Polen and Fatima, both of sixth grade, seventh grade student. I want to, Talukdar sir, please introduce yourself with your seat.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum. Everybody. And peace be upon you and all of the children, those who are here. I was just listening one story from my kids. It's really strike me. And you know, all over the world, many things is happening. The children cannot express by themselves. So it's really very hard for them to survive. Even those they are from a rich family. You already mentioned it depends on the condition of the environment and the psychology and the culture, how we are grow and how we take it in our mind. But this is very important to involve them in our community to express their ideas. So they feel more comfort as they will feel that they have a friend still now on the earth. So at night they will at least able to imagine someone is beside me. So at least she will not going to suicide. She will get her confident that I can survive on the earth and I can do good for the people. Many things happens around us. Even, you know, in Bangladesh, I feel sorrow when I just listen or I just have any video about the children. They're going to suicide for a little something which is not exactly sensitive, but in case of heart, this is more sensitive to heart, especially in Bangladesh. The women, children, our babies, really they are in a big problem. As you know, in third world, there is a crisis of money, there is a crisis of job, especially the people, those who are doing the lower grade jobs, they have a really very weak education. So they are unable to guide the children, unable to cope with the environment. If there is happen anything, they're just stalling their children. That is you, why this is happening. Even they are not allow the children to go outside of the home to talk with other children. You know, this is really very backdated thinking. So we have to arrange such kind of program for the parents also. This is very important. And this is very challenging because parents are not ready to talk with like you and me. They are thinking, oh, this is a waste of time. They will not give me any money. Why should I talk with them? But if we can arrange a group, especially the people from university, the children from university, if we can make them a volunteer to work in the society, if they start to talk, at least in their family, so many problem will be solved. And I feel really sorrow when she was just struggling by herself, how to survive. And ultimately, he overcome that. Thank you. Congratulations. You are the brave person who teach me right now how to survive on the earth. In my old days, I am learning from you. That's really great. You are not only learning from me. And I hope
you
have to keep yourself strong. That's why they can struggle. You can show the people the path, the way, how to survive, how to think. And you know, madam is telling about the butterfly. Really, this is very wonderful when a people or a person can move hither and thither with their wings, with their mindset, with their thinking, then the art will be more good. Thank you very much for allowing me to say something. And I'm really very happy that in your old age, you are working with the children, with the people, with the teacher, all about the art, to aware them how we have to make a path to run in a better world. Thank you very much.
Well, I want to thank you for sharing your thoughts and ideas, and this is you spoke to one of the things that I think is why we all really enjoy and try to come together in our GMRT, because it is a safe place for us to talk about our problems and the things that are going on with us. And the scripts that we write and that we use, it's fascinating, isn't it, Divya? Did we anticipate
no,
that this would bring out this kind of discussion? Not at all. But isn't it wonderful though that it is a place that does allow for these kinds of discussions, and it's a wonderful outlet to be able to share these things and have that support. Divya, I want to say thank you for leading us in this script. You know, I'm not so sure it's not a script that ought to be done again. It really is a pretty powerful script, even though it was to recognize and celebrate the life of Eric Carle and his characters. It's brought up a lot of different ideas and emotions and things that we didn't expect. And that's what makes GMRT, that's what makes this place, this platform,
so special.
It's so different and special. Yes, and really, we are learning a lot about culture here. I'm not so sure. I know for myself, because I've had the opportunity to travel into some of these countries and to see exactly what Nakshi is talking about. And I can't pronounce your name, Shamsuddin, maybe, but you are right. Parents rule their kids and direct them as they expect them to behave, from what I have seen in my travels in India and Africa. And educating the parents is huge. And this is a great platform also to be working with parents and with community, so that they begin to understand perhaps a little differently about the fact that their kids are not dumb. They have much to offer. And I can't tell you how many times we have seen that, Divya, haven't we, in our stories, where it's the child or the youngest that ends up coming in and pointing out what is wrong and what needs to happen oftentimes, but we ignore them and think that they don't have that ability. So it's a great topic, I think, to be thinking about and talking about. I think it is an excellent idea that we should be having parent GMRT sessions, and that we should be having them mixed, so parents hear what our kids, like Nakshi, are saying. Perhaps do a story so that the parents are actually in the child's place and having to go through that, so they can see how that feels and what that means to them. Divya, do you want to end up before we stop the recording and then we'll let Nakshi?
I just had a very wonderful time over here today, because when I was writing the script, it was just with this one thing in my head. There were such diverse opinions over here, which was very, very interesting. And as you have said before, Tracy, I think that whatever state of mind we are at a particular time, so our interpretation of anything we are seeing, listening, or feeling, or touching changes. So I think that's a very good thing. That is what exposure, that's why every GMRT session is a learning session. Because we have one thing in our head, and what we come here, I could have never thought anybody would see the story like that. So it's beautiful. Thank you, Nakshi, for telling us your views on it. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am. Here.